Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is Azure Friday. I'm here with Hariharan Jayaraman. We're talking about the Azure Instance Metadata Service.
Yes.
What is that? That's a complicated thing.
Well, when any VM or any infrastructure service component comes up on Azure,
right.
You need to know some metadata about it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Today, you could source that metadata from when you're deploying that VM and you're burning that information in the VM itself.
Okay.
It kind of gets complicated. Simple scenarios, like I want to run an encryption service, but I don't want to enable 2048-bit encryption in the Asian region. So I just want to enable in the United States.
Okay.
How do I detect where my VM is going to be running? Right. It's a very simple problem. Tell me which region.
I guess I'd have to query the VM and ask it. Hundreds of resources
exactly.
I'd have to be asking about.
Or the VM queries some information about itself and gets, hey, I'm running in US or I'm running in Asia.
Right.
Another simple scenario, I'm going to run a data workload like Cassandra, and I want some safety in my deployment.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be able to find out, tell me which racks these VMs are running so that I can spread my data across. Right. And so how do I get this information about fault domain or update domains that Azure has to provide for safety from within the VM? All this information today gets sent from outside. So what Instance Metadata Service does, it's an unauthenticated endpoint available only to Azure VMs, which you can query on a well-known IP address of 169.254.169.254, and it gives you information about the running VM.
Oh, it lets you know if you're in the matrix or not.
Exactly. Let me quickly show you a quick demo.
That's cool. So it's only available from inside.
Inside the VM.
It tells you about yourself.
Exactly. So I'm right now logged on to an Azure VM.
Okay.
It's a Linux VM. I'm simply going to curl an endpoint.
What a clever idea.
And
so let me break this down. So there's your well-known number.
Exactly.
Easy to memorize
exactly.
Once you've figured it out, because it
right.
Looks like one of those didn't get an IP address, IP addresses.
Exactly. It's an internal IP, and it is actually
yeah.
an IEEE known IP address, which is kept for internal purposes only.
Is it?
Yes.
Okay, so this is a reserved
standard,
IP
yeah.
at
it's
the IEEE
standard.
Level,
yeah.
and then a very easy to understand and versioned API.
Exactly. So you start with the top-level namespace, like metadata, right? And then you get the instance level view by slash instance.
Right.
And all of the APIs are versioned, as you can see.
Yes.
These versions are documented outside, and we don't actually allow latest. Now, here's a quick question. Why won't you allow latest, right?
Hmm.
Azure runs in 36 different regions, and we also have Azure Stack. Think about a developer. What does latest really mean for the developer?
It means,
right?
yeah.
I mean, it can confuse
yeah.
more than actually create realities. So what I've done, I've just used a simple JQ utility, which pretty formats the JSON.
Right,
right?
pretty JSON.
The interface, the API, actually gives you a JSON back. Right? You could also get a text back, right? And I'll show you a quick example of that. So let me break it down as to what you get today. So you get both at a top level, you get a compute as well as network level information.
Mm-hmm.
So in compute, you're looking for what location, the example that I gave you before, what
right.
location am I running? I'm actually running on West Central US right now. This VM is running on West Central US. The name of my VM, right, which was created, which is different than potentially the host name that you chose, in your startup scripts,
mm-hmm.
right? The kind of OS that this is running. And as I said about the fault domain and update domain, this is telling you that this is running on a fault domain, update domain of 0, right? Now, if this VM was an availability set, and I'll give you a quick example shortly, you would see that these numbers would be different. I also get to know what the publisher of this OS is, right? So I know this is a canonical publisher, and I know the version of the Ubuntu that I'm running.
What if this changed internally? If I apt-get dist update, dist upgrade,
yes.
would this know?
Actually, it won't. That's a very good question.
Because this is the where this is where it came from. It's in.
Exactly. This is what the platform thinks you are,
yeah.
right? Azure wants to respect your VM's privacy,
mm.
right? We don't actually go poking around within the VM to find out if you have changed certain
Indeed.
Things.
Indeed. So that's the version of the image when
exactly.
when I was created.
Exactly. Right? And then here's another interesting data point that that is provided. It's called VMID. VMID is a unique identifier for the running VM in Azure for its life cycle. So if you shut down, you start it again, the ID will remain the same. Unless you destroy the VM, you won't change the ID. This is relevant for many telemetry scenarios. So
mm-hmm.
if you're running Datadog, right, on your VM, it needs to know that this instance of VM is different than that instance of VM.
Interesting.
Right? This VM ID gives you that information.
I had a customer ask me recently who is creating a product that they wanted to license
right.
on a VM by VM
Correct.
Basis. Could this be used for them?
Exactly. This enables that scenario where you can use VM ID, and I'll show you what's coming down the road in our preview version shortly, where you can have even more data points to actually tie the licensing together.
It's really great that you're telling me about this, because I can tell you that there have been times when I've wanted this information,
right.
and I've ended up hard coding it in environment variables.
Exactly. And
in order to get it.
I'm here to solve your problem, right? I totally understand that. You know, that is not maintainable, and something becomes crazy. The other important thing that I want to talk about is the VM size.
Mm-hmm.
We actually give you the size of the VM. Now, why is this relevant? You may ask, right? Think about SAP. You're running a big SAP workload, right? Mm-hmm. And then you make a support call to SAP. SAP will want to know, tell me what size of the VM you're running. Maybe you're running it on a standard A2 and being cheap, but SAP is never supposed to run on that kind of configuration.
I see. A tool that could detect it was running in Azure could even
exactly.
then pop up a warning and suggest maybe you don't want to do that.
Yep.
So I could make my application Azure aware by querying that internal address.
That is correct. The other thing that I want to quickly talk about is the other network related information.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, I'm giving you both the internal private IP address, but also the public IP, right? Within a VM running on Azure, you actually do not know what the public IP for that VM is,
mm.
right? And so because all that magic happens at a layer much higher than what the VM is running. So this allows you to know what IPs I'm responding to, so you can do some clever things in terms of your internal telemetry and internal failovers. So with that said, I want to just quickly talk about some semantics that the API provides.
Okay.
Because you would see a JSON and you say, okay, but I'm a shell scripter, right? I don't want to deal with JSON.
Mm.
What am I going to do with this, right? And so the API also allows you to specify a format specifier, which will give you response back in text. Now, this is giving you text response at each level the data represents. So right now, I give you top-level entries of compute and network, right?
Mm.
If you change the API and actually go down the path where after instance I say slash compute, it will let you discover the other data points that are available within compute, and so on and so forth. So if I'm just interested in, say, the offer or the name of the VM, right?
Right, or just the public IP or whatever.
Exactly, right?
You simply path your way down there, which makes your shell scripting much simpler.
Exactly. And a real-life example for this is what Cassandra deployments on Azure is already doing. So here's an example of deploying Cassandra.
I see it right there.
And it tries to get the fault domain. So when the nodes are coming up, it tries to get the fault domain.
Mm-hmm.
And based on the fault domain, it tries to make sure that whenever it's deploying any data sets, the replica sets are kept in different fault area, so that if one fault domain goes down, which means one rack going down
mm-hmm.
in terms of an Azure perspective, you don't lose all of your data. So this is a real life example of what solutions are already using metadata service for.
Will this ever be presented to app service so I could understand the VM that my app service is inside? Because I could see there'd be a lot of value in a similar scenario.
So today, from calling metadata service from within a VM is open to anybody from within the VM as long as they can query this endpoint. Now, within a VM, administrators may choose not to allow every user from within a VM, like an app service user, to query the metadata endpoint. But it's a policy that the administrator of the VM controls. From an Azure point of view, from within a VM, you can call metadata and get interesting information about this. And this is actually by design, because we kept this interface unauthenticated, because
mm-hmm.
authentication is the VM, right? And any component that is coming in to know information can do interesting things. Going forward, real quick on another set of examples that you can do with the metadata endpoint, I just want to give you what is coming in future. So we are revving the version, right?
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, the version was 0.4.0.2. We have a new version that is going to come out, right? Right now, this is a preview version 0.7.0.1, but the release version is going to be 0.8.0.1.
Okay.
I just want to give a quick sneak peek in terms of what's going to come. From a user point of view. So,
I see tags. That's new.
Exactly, right? So you get to see the tags of the running VM, right? Mm-hmm. So if you add a tag, you get to see it here.
So I can stick my own metadata in there and tunnel it in.
Absolutely, right?
Very cool.
And then the other thing that's going to come in is the subscription ID and the resource group name. So you could actually create the resource ID, which is subscription, you know, the resource group name and the VM name, mm-hmm. to actually go and talk to ARM if you have the right service principles available within the VM. So this is something that will unblock a lot of the licensing scenarios that that you talked about earlier, and also, frankly, you know, have richer telemetry. So you actually know if I'm an ISV publishing information in marketplace like Cisco, they would want to know how many different subscriptions are using my image, right? They get to know this right away. Mm-hmm. So you know, this is something that's going to come shortly. Right, we're going to continuously update the service to add more and more data points, right? And connect back with us on feedback.azure.com or send us an email at azureimds@microsoft.
Very cool. And so people can start using this right now. Certainly the April version is around.
Yes.
The August one coming soon.
Correct, exactly. So this API is available. It's generally available on all of public Azure. It's going to be available shortly in all of our national sovereign clouds, like the government cloud in the United States and German or China cloud. And once the new versions are available, the docs that are published in Microsoft Docs, which let me give you a quick sneak peek, will get updated to allow you to have up-to-date information on what is available and what's not available and where all the services are available today.
Fantastic. Right?
And all the service semantics are also a part of this. So you know, I gave you a quick demo of a REST endpoint. You want to know what happens, what is my throttling rate, what is my QPS and other things. All those details and richness are available in the docs.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I am learning all about the Azure Instance Metadata Service here on Azure Friday.